Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is Anandita and you are watching Make It Up. So today I'm back with another video, and today's video is Kim Kardashian inspired Met Gala 2019 inspired makeup look. And this look is a bomb.com, guys. It's gorgeous, it's classic, it's glossy and whatnot. So it was a very fun to create this video because all of the products are very low costed, and I have created a celebrity makeup look, so I'm very glad. I hope you also like this content. If you do so, please don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video with your friends. Now let's get started with the video. So I have already moisturized my face and I'll be putting some liquid highlighter. Here I am using Swiss Beauty liquid highlighter, and I'm just tapping that highlighter on my face. I'm not dragging out the product, or I'm not using any brush or makeup beauty blender, because my hand does the best job when it comes to the liquid highlighter part. So I'm just mixing out all of the products with my finger only. Okay, you can see how glossy my face looks like. And I'm using here MAC foundation, and this shade a little bit darker, so I thought of using this foundation because this look is so bronzy and so browny touch into it. So I'm using this foundation, and I'm using a contour, liquid contour, which is nothing but a foundation, Freedom, I think the brand name is. And I'm putting that contour product on all over my cheekbone area, my jawline area and my forehead. And now I am like putting that contour on my nose also. Now I am taking that Maybelline concealer and putting that concealer on the usual areas, like under my eyes, on my nose, Cupid's bow and forehead. Now it is the time of blending, and you have to blend properly because it is all about blending. Makeup is all about blending and perfection, you know. So you just have to blend all of the products thoroughly. Take your time, whatever time it takes, just put the time into it and blend. So I am blending firstly with a kabuki brush, and then I'll be blending with a damp sponge. So I am using a damp sponge just to soak out the excess product from my face, and moreover blending out all of the products thoroughly. And I am dragging out a little bit product on my lid area also as well. Now I am using this Maybelline compact, and using that compact on all over my face just to dry out the product a little bit, the foundations, the liquid products, concealer and contour, everything. Now I am using this product, which is from Maybelline, and I am using this bronzer powder to a little bit bronze up my face. And on my forehead area also, like my cheekbones area, my jawline area. So I'm basically making my face a little bit bronzy and browny. Okay, now I'm quickly contouring my nose. And her nose, Kim Kardashian's nose, is very snatched and very small. It's a cute little one, but I am not blessed with this kind of nose. My nose is a kind of pakora type, so I'm trying to make it like, it is not possible to make it as thin as hers, but I'm trying to do so. And I'm using a little bit concealer also to make my nose a little bit sharp, you know what I mean. So I'm trying to do this, you can see in the video. And I am patting out the product with the same damp sponge. And now I am using that powder, which is Rimmel London, and it is a translucent powder, it doesn't have any color. And I am using this powder underneath my contour area and my under eye area, just to a little bit bake out my face, not crazily. Now I am using this product, which is a eyebrow pencil, and it is from Wet n Wild, and I'm just little bit filling up my brow lines, and I just want to make my brows a little bit snatched and at the same time bushy like hers only. So I'm just drawing out some lines, like following my natural brow shape, and trying to fill out all of the empty spaces with that brow pencil only. Later on I will use a black eyeshadow and fill my eyebrow. So this palette is everything. For me, this palette is everything. I don't know whether you have heard about this palette or not. It is available in Amazon, I believe. I don't know about some other sites, Nykaa or something like that. I don't know. But I have bought this palette, I think, 3-4 months back, and I'm totally into it. This palette is what can I say? This is everything. It's pigmentation, guys. It's hell pigmented. So I am filling up my eyebrows with that eyeshadow powder, black eyeshadow powder, and now I am just cleaning up my eyebrow edges with the concealer so that everything will be perfect and look snatched and beautiful, you know. So I am little bit putting that concealer on my lid area just to prime my lid. Okay, and now I'm just blending out all of the products all together with the damp sponge. Now I'm taking this brown color. You can use any color, any eyeshadow, whichever you have, and just ensure that powder will be a little pigmented and the color will be dark brown. That's it. So you just have to put that color on your inner corners and the outer corner of the lid. Just firstly placing out that color, and then I am just blending out the colors all together, just filling up the edges of that color. Okay, now I am taking these two colors together and I am just concentrating to put that color on my crease area, and I'm following that brown colors whichever I have placed previously, just to connect that two colors all together with that color. You can see it is a nice transition color has been created, and now I'm taking more brown color and I'm just slowly building up the process so that everything will be seamless and well pigmented. So I am following the same process. I'm just building out the color. Now I'm creating a half cut crease using that same concealer. I have a plan to make a video on how to create a full cut crease and seamlessly and beautifully. All of the description, how to do that, what are the process and everything. So in this video I'll be not talking so much about cut creasing and all. I'm just creating that cut crease. You can see definitely in the video how I'm doing this. And then I am blending out the edges so that everything will be looking seamless and not sharp. Now I am taking this color and I am putting that color on the concealed area. This is a beautiful champagne color which has a beautiful orangish tint into it. And what I am doing is I am trying to dragging out that color a little bit towards my brow bone, because that's what that Kim Kardashian's looks look like. Now I'm taking this color, that brown color again, and I'm just blending out the edges slowly until I get satisfied with the output. Now I'm taking this glitter which is from Lakme. It is a very old one, and I'm just putting that glitter on my that area, on my lid area where I have added that color and creating the half cut crease, and also a little bit dragging out that color towards my brow bone and blending out that color nicely. Now I am dusting away all of the excess powders after baking out my face. Now I'm taking this color and I'm just again, you know, putting some depth like into my eyes, if that makes any sense. Like I was not satisfied with the brown color, so I thought of using this color so that it can make a, you know, a little difference into my eyeshadow look. So I'm putting that color and just like blending out that color with that brown one. And now I'm taking this brown color again and I'm just putting that color under my eye area, like in the waterline area. I'm using this kajal and slowly just filling up my lower waterline. Then I'm coating out my eyelashes with the mascara. Here I'm using the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara, which is all time favorite of mine. It's very beautiful mascara and I'll be not using any falsy today because I thought this look is very gorgeous without any falsy. So I have not used any falsy, but you can definitely use falsy, and Kim Kardashian also used falsy, but I have not. Yep. So you can see definitely how beautiful that mascara is, and almost my look is complete. Now I am like using this color, which is a Mars blusher, and this blusher is hell pigmented. So be very careful while you are putting your blusher, this blusher especially, on your face, because a little goes a long way. And this word's applicable, it's very applicable towards this blusher because it is hell pigmented. So I'll be using that damp sponge also to a little bit dab out that color, because this color is very, very, very pigmented, man. Okay, so this is my favorite part, highlighter. So I'm using this Revolution one and I am, just placing that highlighter on my usual areas, like my brow bone area, my cheekbone area, my nose area, my cupid's bow, my forehead, and where not, everywhere pretty much, because we have to be glossy and we have to be glowy for this look. Okay, so I'm using this. Now I am lining up my lip with this lip color, which is actually a lip pencil, comes from Miss Claire, I think, and it is a beautiful brown color. So I am firstly lining up my lips a little bit broadly because my lips are very small, you guys definitely know, and very thin, but hers are surgical lips and it was very broad, so that's why I am a little bit overdrawn my lip. Now I am taking this color, which is from NYX, and like putting that color on my lips. After that I'll be taking another color, which is a little bit lighter and a little bit pinkish nudish color. I am mixing out all of the colors all together with a lip brush, and then I am using a Vaseline just to make out that glossy finish, because I don't have any lip gloss, so I'm using Vaseline. So this is the final result. I am totally into this look. I don't know whether you guys will like this or not, but I am definitely fond of this look. I will definitely create this look in some of the party or some of the occasion. So yeah, this is it, and be happy, be healthy, be beautiful, as I always say. Bye bye.